Well, very simple. They released a letter that they will not comment. But it's not unexpected. I mean, I don't think that they really want to inform people what was going on. The only thing we do know is that apparently the whole extradition took longer, specifically because they twice interrogated, or whatever you will call it, interviewed Tsemakh. So I think that's a very good thing. What is interesting, of course, and what we don't know is whether there was any specific requests from the Netherlands to Ukraine not to release Tsemakh. But on the other hand, Jeroen Akkermans, a well-known Dutch journalist who is always involved in Eastern European affairs, said if Netherlands would be in such a position, maybe they would do the same thing. I mean, it was an impossible choice here, I guess. Yeah, that's an interesting question. So they did interview him. There are two options here. Either, I think it might be more, but I'm not sure how legally that can be used. I mean, the moment that it was known that he was captured, he was also, of course, interrogated. So I think it's not only the two interviews that were done by Dutch government, but also the one that, or maybe several interviews, investigations that Ukraine did after the moment he was captured. I'm not sure how that is legally, if Ukraine does these interrogations or interviews, whether that can actually be used. Apparently, the Dutch government did see a need to do their own talks with Tsemakh. Yeah, and they will never, the only moment that we will learn what the result is of these talks will be the court case itself, I presume. Yeah, the interesting thing is that, yes, even though Russia vetoed this United Nations tribunal, I think everybody signed, including Russia, to help with this investigation. So it would make sense that there is some request for extradition. But the Russian embassy in The Hague specifically tweeted that they did not receive such a request. And this tweet was even liked or even retweeted by the Dutch, the Russian Foreign Ministry. So as far as the this request goes, I did not see evidence that it was done. But that doesn't mean that it may not happen. So we don't know. I don't know. Maybe not. But still, the time needs to tell. I mean, it all depends on the discussions between Dutch government and maybe Jit, who's in charge of the MH17 investigation, and Ukrainian officials. So the moment that Ukraine managed to convince Dutch government or maybe Jit that for the only possibility to get these Ukrainians home is deliver Tsemakh, yeah, then there might have been nothing spoiled in this relationship. And anyways, I mean, there are so many economic ties, and Ukraine is part of this investigation. I don't think so, but I hope not. But the setback is that, and this comment, I was in Kharkiv, I returned on Saturday, funny enough, exactly during the moment that this extradition took place. I was in Borispol Airport. I think that this seems to a lot of Ukrainians and Dutch people like bowing to Russia again, because in the end, well, they did let Tsemakh go. But still, we shouldn't forget that there are four suspects with top number one, Strelkov, who may never in person appear in court. That was already done in June. The key thing here, and that could have been a very important thing, is that this Tsemakh could have been in court in person, maybe. And that seems no longer possible. And I doubt that even if there will be an official request for extradition, that Russia will deliver him. I mean, if they want him so badly that they threw him in as part of the deal to get the Ukrainians home, then it seems very important for them to get Tsemakh. And I think that's an important thing here, because it almost seems like admitting guilt in this case. I mean, it didn't seem some sort of extremely powerful, valuable asset in this whole war in Ukraine. I definitely saw a number of relatives of the MH17 victims. Yeah, that were really shocked that this actually happened. But in their case, I think that should be the number one reaction. And we have to understand that even for Ukraine, this is also a big loss. I mean, the probably the top example that this is a Russian war going on in eastern Ukraine is the fact that they even delivered this this book installation and shot down the plane. So that's not just the Netherlands that wants justice here. It's everybody in Ukraine as well.